corporations now have the same rights as people.
Another music icon overdoses on me.
Day three of the labor strike.
Officer involved shooting, six of the lives.
Cyberbullied team.
You have your facts, and we have alternative facts.
Neo-Nazi rally erupts in violence.
You say spying on history. Suicide rates in the U.S. in an all-time high.
A new opioid crisis.
Demonstrations continued in the capital.
17 dead at a Florida high
school. Torn. What?
Sometimes things feel like they're too much to handle. You may be able to pull it together and put on a front in front of others, but inside, you're trapped by your own anxiety, suffocating slowly. The colors of life washed away, covered by a thick, dark sadness. Most days I could barely fathom getting out of bed, just lying there, half awake, half alive, scared even of sleep, and the night terrors that would meet me there.
Got too many people. Da-da-da-da. Got left to prove wrong. All those motherfuckers. Da-da-da-da. Been too mean for too long. And I'm so sick of crying. Could fight forever, oh, but life's too short. Don't let the bastards get you down. Oh no, don't let the assholes wear you out. Don't let the mean girls take the crown. Don't let the scumbags screw you around. Don't let Don't let the bastards get you down. Oh no, don't let the assholes wear you out.
I may have been ready to give up on myself, but I wasn't ready to give up on my fans, because they had never given up on me. They wrote me letters, and they stood up for me when I couldn't stand up for myself. I didn't have any new music out. I just threw together a band with some friends. We rehearsed for like 2 days, and we played our first gig at my favorite dive bar in Nashville. Kesha and the Creepies was born.
I know I haven't put out a record in a while, but I'm gonna put out my old music the way I fucking like it. So I hope you guys enjoy.
My boyfriend made the logo. We reinvented old songs and played covers. And for the first time since high school, I was just playing live music for the thrill of it. We played rock clubs, dive bars, and then the venues started to get bigger again. Safety nets, just pure adrenaline and raw energy. We did whatever the fuck we wanted. Off the stage, I may have felt trapped, but on the stage, I was fucking free. And the energy I received every night from my fans kept me going.
Thank you for standing by me. I honestly don't know if I would have made it the past 3 years without you guys.
When I wrote Rainbow, I was in a very dark place. I was alone, and I was scared. And I was in rehab for an eating disorder that had gotten wildly out of control. They said I wasn't allowed to work. And since I'm a musician, they said I couldn't even have a keyboard. But I pleaded, this isn't work. Finally, they agreed to give me a keyboard for 1 hour a day. I knew I had to change and learn to take care of and love myself. Rainbow was the beginning. When I finally had the chance to record the song, I called up my friend Ben Folds to help me arrange and produce it.
And darling, our scars make us who we are. And when the winds are howling strong and you're thinking you can't go on, and then insert genius line I have yet to write.
Yeah, well. And there, you have mentioned darkness before, so you've already been in the dark once.
And I know, but I'm explaining what happened.
You want to stay there.
I don't want to be in the dark. But then this is saying, like, what happened in the dark, but I realized life is short.
No, it's good. You convinced me.
Oh, put those colors on, girl. Come and paint the world red and white.
Okay. awesome, like, arrangement, by the way. I have a couple lyrical moments I want to change, but that's me.
Regan!
Yeah?
Hold tight, sweetheart, after the dark. Will you write it down, though?
Yeah, comes what? Comes...
Comes a rainbow! Rainbow, baby, trust me, I know!
After the thunderstorm comes a rainbow, rainbow. Like layer. Mm-hmm. I was just thinking like an outro, we could layer shit on top.
So I think we go one quiet.
Baby, trust me, I know life is scary, but just put those colors on, girl. You gotta learn to live. Trust me, I know the ghosts will try to find you, but just put those colors on, girl. Come and paint the world with me tonight. Ooh, I, come and paint the world with me tonight.
So, after I got out of rehab for my eating disorder, the only way I really know how to cope with things is writing songs about everything. And I try to make something beautiful, or at least just something. It doesn't even have to be beautiful. Some of the art's not beautiful. Some of it's painful, or some of it's aggressive, or some of it's gnarly. And that's when you come up with the stuff that, like, gives you goosebumps.
I'm a motherfucking woman!
I feel like the high notes, like the payoff. So I like waiting for it, but I also like hearing it the first time. So I don't know. I gotta go back and forth.
You can do both. What do you think? That's something else.
I'm looking at this record and as myself and as this whole journey as if I'm a new artist. Like the first time anyone's getting to know me because this was all in my head. This is the album I've always dreamt of making.
I'm Kesha, and the name of my new record is called Rainbow. I'm gonna cry a lot.
Okay.
The name of my record is called Rainbow, and I called it Rainbow because it's after the storm. There's a rainbow. And I wrote it as a message to myself that I could make it through it. So that's why I'm crying a lot. It's because this feels really real.
I mean, it's such the, it's so deep and personal talking about some really depression, suicide. Just tell us the meaning behind praying. Okay.
It's so personal. I've written every song on this album and they're all so personal. And this song I think is just really important. Because it talks about me personally going through something very hard, lots of very hard things, making it through, not giving up, and finding empathy on the other side, which is incredibly hard sometimes.
How has that music, though, helped you through this difficult time?
Well, I think this record has quite literally saved my life. Mm. And I hope you guys like it, and I hope you can hear it, and I hope it helps people.
The artist Kesha receives her first ever Grammy nomination for her album Rainbow. She scores
Rainbow was my first album that I had complete creative control over. Everything was me. This was so liberating, and it was terrifying. Everything was on me. Its success was so overwhelming. This was me, Kesha Rose Siebert, being myself publicly for the first time ever.
One more time.
When the Grammys called and said not only was my album nominated, but they also wanted me to perform, it was a dream come true. But it also triggered my intense anxiety. This song was incredibly hard to sing on such a grand stage, both emotionally and technically.
I found a strength.
Let go now.
Okay,
one more time.
It's
so sad up there.
One more time. You say string. Okay, you strangle string.
How do I get that?
It should be open. You should be talking. Say string.
Strength.
Oh, not strength.
Strength.
Sing it now, just like that.
I found the strength of never known.
Listen to this. Come back over, Kesha. Come back over.
I'm very frustrated.
Why?
Because I sing it really good sometimes and I don't, and like sometimes my voice like cracks. And that's the line about strength. When I'm there and there's all the people and there's Beyonce, I want to do a good job and I want to fucking kill it. And
let's
like,
go again.
I feel like I'm going to get impassioned.
You're going to get impassioned.
And then I'm going to want to go harder because that's like what I've always been taught is like, you go harder and that's better, and like sometimes it's not better.
Drop your jaw. Woo. Drop your jaw. Thank you.
Just lighten up everything up, way up, lighten it up. Just.
Well, I'm singing a not light song at the Grammys. It's not light.
Listen, you gotta learn to let go.
I'm trying to let go of it.
Ladies, come over real quick. All ladies, over here real quick.
Look at me. You do not have to sing this heavy to prove anything. No. You need to tell the doggone story and stop trying to prove. And you were courageous enough to write a song about your experience to share that with the rest of the world. So deal with the pain, but you share your love on stage. You get out there and you sell the lyric. Let's do this thing from the top, y'all.
Ladies and gentlemen, Kesha. We take 10 minutes and collect ourselves, and then we'll try this again.
So we went through the song. I think we should do that one more time because it put us in a really good position. Let's talk through the lyrics. Because
I can make it on my own.
Because what?
Isn't that right?
Yes. Because I can what?
Because I can make it on my own.
Absolutely. That's the part you're fighting. You should let it go there.
But I think it's hard for me to say that line.
It's the most liberating line in the whole song because...
No shit, that's why it's hard to say it.
To say that at the Grammys that you're performing on and that you're nominated for an album that you did on your own?
No, oh, I know.
That doesn't make any sense.
At all. It's a dichotomy of life.
I know. Like, just remember that I already did make it on my own.
Kesha.
Maybe that's my mantra for the next 2 days.
Kesha.
Like, I already made it on my own.
I can make it on my own.
I can make it on my own.
A little louder, one more time.
I can make it on my own.
What?
I can make it on my own.
Go for it. Thank you. We don't need anything else.
Okay.
Vocal rest. Great place.
I can breathe again. And you said that I was done. Well, you were wrong, and now the best is yet to come. 'Cause I can make it on my own. Just unhappy, the
get feet.
Give feet.